Hi guys, welcome to Azure Content. This is part 6 in Mapping Data Flow Scenarios playlist. In this video, we are going to learn how to flatten the nested JSON using Mapping Data Flow. So let's see what our requirement is. So in this video, we want to transform the nested JSON by flattening it, and then we want to convert it into object of an array. Okay. So if you take a look into the first image, which is the source data. So here we have a JSON. It has a property called value, which is of array format. And inside this array, there are two items. One is this one and another one is this one. Okay. And in each of the arrays, there are few properties like ID, which has some value, the name, which has some value. And then there's properties, which is having the value as a JSON, okay, as it is a key value pair, okay. So what we need to do is we need to flatten this data and we need to have this display name as a property instead of being the nested JSON inside one property, okay. So it should also be coming as a column like these ID and names are there, okay. So how to implement this? So once this data has been flattened and we get two rows, one for each of the items and these three columns, then what we need to achieve is we want to convert those columns again in back in the form of this array. Okay. And we want to store this inside the JSON file. Okay. So the only change will be this property will be skipped. This object will not be there. Okay. Anymore. Only ID name and display name will be there. Okay. So let me go back to the ADF pipeline and let me try to implement this. Okay. So I have created a data set which is pointing to that source file present in my ADLS. Okay. So here's how the data looks like and the data set is pointing to the same. Okay. So the data looks good. Now let me start creating a new data flow. I've already turned this data flow debug option. Okay, let me create a new source transformation and select that JSON as the dataset. Now, as you remember from our previous video, we have to select the type of JSON here, okay, inside this source option, JSON settings. So let me select array of document and let me hit. So now everything is contained inside this value column. So here inside that value, there are two items. As you can see here, one is this one, another one is this one. So inside value one, we have ID name and inside properties, we have that display name. Similarly for value two, where we will be having same kind of data. So now the first thing that we need to do is we need to flatten this data. Okay. And we need to convert it into individual rows. So for that, I will use flatten transformation. So if you have watched my previous videos, this implementation will look simple for you. So because we have already tried to cover these transformations in our previous videos. Okay. So here what we need to do is we need to select the array which we need to unroll. Okay. So here's only one array. So let me click on value. Now we need to select the columns that we want as our output. Okay. So first of all, let me delete this and let me select ID. And the name by default it came as ID, which is fine. Let me add another mapping for name. Okay, and the column name will be name. And then let me select display name. Okay, so this will be coming as a third column. So let me preview the data now. So now we have three columns, ID, name and display name. Okay, and it has two rows, which depicts that there are two items of that array. Okay, now what we want to achieve is we want to convert these three columns into JSON again, into this format. Okay. So for that, so first of all, let me add a sync transformation to copy this data and store it into one CSV. And then we will do the data transformation again to convert it into JSON. And then we will store it as a JSON format. So first of all, let me add a sync transformation here. Okay. And then let me create a data set pointing to my Gentoo account and let me add a CSV format. Okay. Let me go to demo and output folder. So the output file will reside into the demo output folder. And then as we have to store it in a single file, there is a setting here that we need to select. Okay, in this file name option, we need to select this output to single file. And here we will give the name as CSV output dot CSV. Okay, and let me set single partition. When we selected this single partition, it actually applied this single partition in optimize tab. Okay, and now let me add another sync transformation. Now the output of the flattened transformation will be stored in two sync, okay, two destination file. But before that, before loading it to the second file, what we need to achieve is we need to convert these column values into object of array. Okay, we need to store it like in this format in the JSON file. Okay, so for that, before this sync, let me add aggregate function. Okay, so it went here, so it's not a problem. So if you remember, in part 4 of our mapping data flow playlist, we have talked about collect function, which converts everything into array. Okay, so we will use that function to convert our data into array format. Okay, this group by option is optional. Okay, it is not mandatory, so we will skip that and we will go to this aggregate tab, and here I will create another column called value. So here we need to provide the expression. So I'll make use of collect function, which converts the values provided here into array. Okay, so what happens if I just select ID or any of the column? Let me just take a look on the data. Okay, so value is coming as the array, and you can see value 1 is having this data, value 2 is having this data, and this is the data of ID column, but the column name ID is not appearing. So let me add the rate, and then let me add ID equals to. So what it will do, it will assign this name as the column name for the value which is stored in this ID. Okay, so let me hit data preview again. So now let's have a look on the data. So now you can see inside the value array, you can see ID is the column name and this is the value for this column. Okay, so similarly, what we will do, we will concatenate other columns here itself. Okay, so let me give name equals to this name value, and then the third column name is display name. Okay, so display name equals to display name. Okay, now save and finish. Let me refresh the data again. Now let's see the data. So it's coming perfectly. So inside this value array, these three columns are present and the values are also coming correctly. Okay, now inside this sync, let me create another data set which will be of JSON type. Okay, and let me select the linked service, and let me select the path for that output folder. Okay, and here, as I told, we need to give single partition. Okay, we will give the name as JSON output. Okay, let me select single partition. Now let me create a pipeline to run this data flow. Okay, so let's wait for this execution to be completed. So the data flow execution is completed. Now let's go to the output folder and see if our data is coming perfectly or not. Okay, so inside this output folder, there are two output files. Okay, one is in CSV format. Let me check the data. So you can see these columns are coming, but the header is missing, right? We will take a look on that, why the header is missing. And let's go to the JSON output and see the data. So here you can see, this is the JSON, and value is coming as the array, and these are the properties, ID, name and display name. Similarly, the second item or second object is having ID, name and display name. Okay, so this is what we wanted to achieve. Now coming back to this CSV, here why we are not getting header, because let me go to the data flow again. And in this sync one, let me go to the data set, and we have to select this first row as a header. Okay, now let me run the pipeline again. Okay, So now the data flow execution is completed. Now let's go back to this output.csv file and hit refresh. Okay. So now you can see the column name are also coming correctly. Okay. So this is how we can flatten the nested JSON and convert it into objects of array and load it into separate sync file as well. Okay. So that's it, guys. I hope you like this video. Please keep supporting this channel by hitting on like button. Please subscribe this channel if you haven't done it yet. Thank you. Please stay tuned.